Hi, hello. I hope everybody can see me and hear me clearly. Just let me know with a positive or negative response. You can give me a thumbs up and tell me whether I'm visible and you can hear me clearly or not. And then we'll start with the remaining session. We'll try and cover the entire June flashcards at least, and probably start with October as soon as we're done with June. Perfect. Okay. My exam is in the afternoon shift, I believe sector 34 or something in Gurgaon. So yeah, that's the place and the location and the time that I have. Okay, so if you have access to flashcards, open page 27, I believe. Yes, page 27, question 3, that's what we are going to start with. One second, please. Okay. So I hope you can see question 3. The question is, with which organization has Asian Development Bank signed a cooperation agreement to promote private sector investment in Asia and Pacific regions? Asian Development Bank has cooperated with which organization to promote private sector investment in the Asian and Pacific region? Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency, MIGA, IMF, International Monetary Fund, not FIND, WTO, IORA, Indian Ocean Rim Association, or none of the above? Let's have the answer, guys. Somebody says MIGA. Okay, more answers coming in with MIGA as the answer. Let's have the answer, guys. Lot of students watching, lot of students coming in. Let's have the answer as fast as possible. Anybody who thinks the answer is anything other than MIGA, please come forward. Do not be shy. Do not think that if you're wrong, it'll be a disaster. It'll be beneficial for you, because then you would never forget this particular question at least. Okay. Yes, Asian Development Bank and MIGA have signed a cooperation for 3 years in line with 2030 Sustainable Development Goals. The purpose is to promote private sector investment in Asian and Pacific region. Next question. Total horticultural production in 2018-19, according to second advanced estimate released by Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare, total horticulture production in 2018-19. 110 million tons, 444, 590, 314, or 115. What is the answer, guys? Let's have the answer of this question as fast as possible. What is the total horticultural production in 2018-19 according to Department of Agriculture under Ministry of Agriculture? 110 million tons, 444, 590, 314, or 115. D, that is 3414. That's what everybody is saying. Anyone who thinks the answer is not 314 million tons, the answer is something else. Rishabh says E, 115 million tons. Let's see if we have some other answers as well. No, that's all we have. So D and E, the confusion is between D, 314, and E, 115. The gap is huge. As per Department of Agriculture, yes, the total horticultural production is 314 million tons, which is 1.01% higher than 2017-18. So the growth rate is horrible, I can say that. Not even at par with standards of agriculture, but that's how the agriculture in India is. Total production of major food crops as per third advanced estimates of 2018-19. Third advanced estimates of 18-19, total food production. Now this is 18-19, that was 17-18, remember that. That's why that was revised estimate. This is advanced estimate. 290, 380, 540, 283, or 890. Not very sure of that as well. Okay, says 283. Some students saying 283 million tons. Third advanced estimates major food production, total production of major food crops. 283 million tons, is that the right answer? Let's see if the answer is 283 or if the answer is something else. We're talking about third advanced estimates 2018-19. Okay, this is where we get everything. Yes, 283 million tons in financial year 90 according to the advanced estimates. Food grains, as is mentioned here, 283 million tons, out of which rice is 115, wheat is 101. All these are not very important. The least is 3.5 here of tur. Oil seeds 31.4 million tons. Cotton is important, 27.5 million tons. And sugarcane 400 million tons. That's a lot. So all these are very important. Please remember them as per third advanced estimates 283 for food crops. Next question, which ministry operates the sample registration system? It is the census of births and deaths of and population growth. Census of births and deaths and population growth, sample registration system, which ministry? Ministry of Public Utilities, Personnel, Health and Family Welfare, Home Affairs, Women and Child Development. Let's have the answer, guys. Let's see who gets to the answer the fastest. In this question, which ministry operates sample registration system? Ministry of Health says Juhi. Somebody says D, Ministry of Home Affairs. So already two answers coming in. Jayan says C, Navneeta says C, Kambali says D. Lot of C's and D's, confusion there. Juhi not sure about the answer. These kinds of questions are specifically asked in phase 2, more in phase 2 than in phase 1. But for phase 1 as well, they are important. One second, please. Data from sample registration system shows that India's infant mortality rate has fallen from 44 to 33. Global average IMR is 29, and that for, so it does not mention whether it is released by which ministry. Let me see. Sample registration system, a part of sample registration survey only, I believe, released by, I would not say not released by this, not released by Public Utilities, not released by Home Affairs. So either it is Ministry of Health and Family Welfare or Women and Child Development. Because we are talking about births, deaths and population, so it should be Women of Health and Family Welfare rather than Women and Child Development. Because we are not only talking about Women and Child Development, we are talking about the entire health and family welfare through all these three things: population growth, family welfare, births and deaths, the condition of health of people in our country. Therefore, it should be ideally health and family welfare. Okay. Yes, the updated IMR also, I believe, I had discussed. So let's forget about this one as well. Okay, sample registration survey just came out with the recent ones. Amount of total bank frauds in 2018-19 as per RBI. Amount of total bank frauds in 2018-19 as per RBI. 71,000 crore, 11,000, 41,000, 21,000 or 81,000. The numbers are far away. Therefore, it should not be a problem in identifying the right answer if you have read it already. Amount of total bank frauds in 2018-19 as per RBI. Let's have the answer, guys. Yes, that's what I thought. So a lot of students saying a 71,000 crore. Madhu says E. So we have someone saying 81,000 crore as well. Okay. Majority students saying A, but some students also saying that it should be E. Let's see. RBI reveals bank frauds 71,000 crore, reaching above the number of cases 6801. Not important. anything else is not very important. Next question, theme of financial literacy week 2019. This is important, I think. You can mark it, give it a double star. Financial literacy week 2019, what was the theme? Women, farmers, disabled people, startups or banks? I think SRA should not be Ministry of Home Affairs. Let me okay, let's say confusion between farmers and startups, lot of confusion between farmers and startups. Let's see what the right answer is. RBI is observing financial literacy week with the theme of farmers. To create financial awareness among bank customers about financial products, FAME, financial awareness messages booklet, which provides basic financial literacy messages for information to general public. The theme is important, I think, and that's what is mentioned here. Anything else is not very important. About the other question, I believe he is right. Sample registration survey, Registrar General of India. So through that logic, it should be Ministry of Home Affairs. So the confusion is between Ministry of Home Affairs and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Okay, but because it's a survey, so surveys normally are conducted by Registrar General and they come under Ministry of Home Affairs. So confusion there, you can check it. According to the large exposure norms for banks released by RBI, total exposure of banks to one counterparty do not exceed dash of tier 1 capital. Large exposure norms for banks released by RBI. Recent changes were also being carried out in large exposure framework. According to that, what is the total exposure which is allowed? And exposure of banks to NBFCs. I think there was something along those lines as well, if I'm not wrong. 2% and 5% confusion there. A 2%, B 5%. If was there anything related to large exposure framework with respect to exposure of banks to NBFCs? If there was, what were the numbers of that exposure framework? Okay, majority students saying 2%. Large exposure norms for banks, what does it say? Yes, total exposure of to one counterparty does not exceed 5% of tier 1 capital. Banks need to include indirect exposure along with direct exposure while calculating total exposure, provided it is above 0.25% of tier 1 capital. If indirect exposure is more than 0.25%, then you need to include it. Exposure limit of banks in individual and collected companies was 25% and 25% of banks' capital base respectively. Banks to NBFC is 20%, correct. So it is 2 and 20. That way you can try and remember it. 20% is correct there. Next question, what is the global GDP growth rate from 2019-20 according to World Bank? The numbers have been revised again and again, so this might not tell us the correct answer. I believe World Bank I had taken as the base when I was talking about indices, when I was talking about GDP numbers. So I had taken one base number, and based on that base number I had calculated or tried to remember all the other numbers, right? So I don't remember what exactly was it. I think it was 3%, 2.6 or 2.7%, something like this. Majority of the students are saying 2.6% for 19-20. Let's see if that is the correct answer, because that was the base that we took when we were talking about. Somebody says 1.7 as well. Let's see. 2.6% from 2.9%. So it has been revised downwards to 2.6%. Okay. Not a very difficult question if you remember and if you have revised it n number of times. Next question, according to Department for DPIIT, basically overall FDI outflows fell by 1% to dash for the first time in 6 years in 2018-19. According to DPIIT, overall FDI inflows, sorry, not outflows, fell by 1% to dash 44, 21, 55, 90 and 27. Let's have the answer, guys. No, the revised, by revised, World Bank's number is not revised, but not revised after June. It was last revised in June only. It is still 2.6%. Various other organizations have revised it. And I had taken World Bank's data as the base of trying to remember all the other data points given by other organizations. If you go and check that video on GDP growth, you would know it. 44.37 billion. Yes, that is the correct answer. 44.37 billion revised downwards. 44.37. Okay. FDI inflows in services sector grew by 36% to 9 billion. So out of this 44, 9 billion is in services and the remaining is in industry, agriculture, construction, whatever. Singapore is the top source of FDI in 2018-19. So that is something that you need to remember. Second, Mauritius. Third, Netherlands. First and second most important. First being the most important one. Who will head the Committee on Development of Housing Finance? Next question. Committee on Development of Housing Finance Securitization Market. Who is going to be the head? We had talked about it. Housing Finance Securitization Committee recommendations. We had talked about it in the Finance Current Affairs video as well, if I'm not wrong. Let's have the answer, guys. What is the answer for this? Housing Finance Securitization Market. Who is the head of the committee? Harshvardhan, V.G. Kannan, N.K. Singh, Ram Gopalachari. Ashok Lavasa says A. Harshvardhan. A lot of people saying A. Harshvardhan. Let's confirm this answer. Everybody says A. Harshvardhan. If anybody thinks the answer should not be A, you can come out with the answer. Okay, perfect. Yes, the answer is Harshvardhan. Six-member task force on development of secondary market by T.N. Manoharan. We had discussed, I think, both the committees. What is the purpose of task force on development of secondary market for corporate loans formed by RBI? This is an interesting question. What is the purpose of task force on development of secondary market for corporate loans? It is formed to review the existing state of the market for loan sale or transfer. It is formed to review the economic capital framework. It is formed to review the mortgage securitization market. It is formed to facilitate loan transfer facilities to MSMEs and all of the above. Which of the following is the correct answer? Let's have the answer, guys. The options are in front of you. It is formed to review the existing state of the market for loan sale or transfer, for economic capital framework, to review the mortgage securitization market in India, to facilitate loan facilities to MSMEs, or all of the above. The question says, which of the following is the main purpose of development of secondary market for corporate loans? Secondary market for corporate loans, that's the question. Let's have the answer, guys. Of course, it's a lengthy question, so going to take more time. Somebody says E, all of the above. Somebody says D, MSME. Somebody says A. Somebody says B. Can it be B, Economic Capital Framework of RBI? That was headed by Bimal Jalan and the purpose was something else. Okay, so we can remove B. If B is removed, E is automatically removed. Let's have a look at the answers. Okay, to review the existing state of market for loan or sale or transfer in India, as well as international experience in loan trading, and to make recommendations to develop the secondary market in corporate loans. The question itself answers it actually. The question says secondary market in corporate loans, which means this is individual A, this is bank, let's say B1, and this individual A takes a bank and let's say keeps a house as a mortgage, right? Now the bank wants to sell off this corporate loan, or it's a corporate loan. So let's say it's company A, not person A, company A takes up and puts something as collateral. And the banks wants to trade this corporate loan because the entire collateral is lying idle with the bank. So if there is a secondary market, the bank cannot trade this loan in the market. Buyers who are interested in buying off this loan can actually buy it from bank B1 directly. So the purpose is to review the existing state of market for loan or sale or transfer. Loan, sale or transfer, creating a review structure for that. It is not for securitization. So we are not, because we are not creating another derivative, we are just selling the loan in the secondary market, right? And not to facilitate loan or transfer facilities to MSMEs. Therefore, D is also out. I hope you understood it. Next question, which two banks have been included in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934? Which two banks have been included in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934? The options are in front of you. Please answer them as fast as possible. So the answer of previous question came out to be A, if you're still not clear. Let's have the answer, guys. Mortgage securitization was by Harshvardhan. Corporate loan secondary market was by T.N. Manoharan. So both these have different objectives. Okay. Everybody saying A, Finke Small Finance Bank Limited and Cookman Bank. Mukesh says B, Group Finance and Bandhan Bank. Which two banks have been included in second schedule of RBI Act? Somebody says E, Dena Bank and Vijaya Bank. Somebody says B. Okay, let's see. Finke Small Finance Bank, Cookman Bank. That is A, right? So the answer is A of this one. Next question, which of the following statement is true about new prudential framework for resolution of stressed assets? Longer questions now. This new framework has also included small finance bank, small banking finance and NBFCs along with banking system. It allows lenders to initiate legal proceedings within 30 days of default. It provides a greater degree of flexibility to banks. RBI circular also necessitated signing an inter-creditor agreement. So inter-creditor agreement, important or mandatory in now. Let's have the answer, guys. Which of the following is a part of new framework released by RBI? Has included small banking finance and NBFCs, allows lenders to initiate legal proceeding within 30 days, provides more flexibility to banks for resolving NPAs, necessitated inter-creditor agreement, or all of the above. Some students saying B, some students saying E, all of the above. The answer in my view should be E. Let's see what the answer is. Let's read through it. Prudential framework for the resolution of stressed assets released by RBI. Banks to initiate legal proceedings within 30 days. Okay, so this is correct. Also included small banking finance and NBFCs along with banking system. So A is also correct. If A and B both are correct, that means it's all of the above. Necessitated signing of ICA, according to which any decision agreed upon by lenders representing 75% of value or 60% of lenders by number is to be binding on all the parties which are a part of inter-creditor agreement. So yes, all four, A, B, C and D are correct answers. Next question, which company has become the first one in India to open a side pocketing account for its illiquid assets? First one in India to open a side pocketing account for its illiquid assets. Reliance, ICICI, Aditya Birla, UTI or Tata? Let's have the answer, guys. Everybody saying Tata Mutual Fund. Tata Mutual Fund has become the first company to launch a side pocketing account by using SEBI's guidelines. Okay, a side pocketing account allows a mutual fund to segregate or put aside their illiquid assets into a separate account. So whatever illiquid assets are there in your mutual fund, you can put them in a separate account. What is the meaning of a leverage ratio? So this is a phase 2 type question, not a phase 1 type question, but let's discuss it. What is the meaning of leverage ratio? Ratio of liquid assets to current liabilities, ratio of efficiency of operations of business based on effective utilization of resources, analyzes profits in relation to revenue from operations, proportion of current assets to current liabilities, it analyzes company's robustness in the face of financial obligations. A very lengthy question, but you can try and answer it. A phase 2 type question, not a phase 1 type question. What is the meaning of leverage ratio? Ratio of liquid asset to current liability measures the efficiency of operation of business based on effective utilization of resources. How efficient you are in operation of business based on what? Based on utilization of resources. Profits in relation to revenue from operations. Out of revenue, how much profits are you earning? Proportion of current assets to current liabilities and company's robustness in the face of financial obligations. So these are the options that you have. Leverage ratio. Somebody says B, somebody says E. Majority students saying E, some students saying B. Okay, let's have a look at the discussion. RBI has declined the leverage ratio for banks to 4%. For DSIBs, it is now 3.5%. The purpose is to boost lending activities. Leverage ratio is the percentage of banks' exposures. Banks' exposures has set the minimum requirement for leverage ratio at 3%. Measures the amount of capital raised by a company in the form of debt. So whatever your capital has been raised, let's say you raise rupees 100. Now out of that rupees 100, 20 rupees come in the form of debt. You take a loan. And 80 rupees come in the form of equity. That means you create some shares and you sell those shares to interested parties. So out of the amount of capital, how much is it in the form of debt is called as leverage ratio, to check the robustness of a company to pay its financial obligation at the due time. So if your leverage ratio is very high, then your obligations, mandatory obligations also increase. If your leverage ratio is too low, your mandatory obligations reduce, but at the same time, your obligations go down, but if you're making profits, you have to distribute more profits. So it analyzes the company's robustness in the face of financial obligations. When your financial obligations are too high, the company's robustness goes down. Okay. Yes, debt obligations. So the answer certainly is E. It is not for phase one. Phase 2 kind of a question put here. What is the GDP growth rate of India for 2019 as projected by G20 surveillance note? GDP growth rate of India for 2019 projected by G20. 6.7, 3.1, 6.1, 7.1 or 7.3. Let's have the answer, guys. Akansha says B, 3.1, or is that for the last question? E 7.3, somebody says 6.7, somebody says C, 6.1, somebody says A. So a lot of confusion. What is it? G20 surveillance note anticipated India's growth to be 7.3 in 2019, 7.5 in 2020, and global rate 3.6%. So these are the important numbers that you have to remember. We've already discussed a lot of these questions. It's your duty to keep revising them again and again. If you don't revise it again and again and again, you will never be able to remember them at the end, towards the examination. Next question, which company is the world's most valuable brand according to Brand Z Top 100 Most Valuable Global Brand Ranking 2019? According to Brand Z, world's most valuable brand. Google, IBM, Microsoft, Amazon or Flipkart. Let's have the answer, guys. A very phase one type of a question. Let's have all of you answer at least this one correctly. We've been taking some difficult questions, some difficult shots. Amazon. Okay, everybody says Amazon. Everybody sticks with Amazon. Anybody who thinks that the answer is not Amazon? World's most valuable brand at $315 billion, according to Brand Z, top 100 most valuable global brand rankings. Okay, released by WPP's research agency Kantar. Apple is second most, first is Amazon. Google is third, Microsoft is fourth, and Visa is fifth. Somebody is asking, I've completed 6 months current affairs, getting around 30 plus general awareness in mocks. I don't know from where have you covered them, Prince. So that's why I cannot tell you what is the reason. Or see those questions, why are you getting 30 plus? Is your accuracy low? Have you gone through them already? Or are they new questions? Next question. Which South African country has received 150 million of LOC, line of credit, or LC from Exim Bank of India for agriculture development? Which, not South African, which African country, I would say. Which African country has received 150 million LC from Exim Bank of India for agricultural development? Everybody says Guinea. Somebody says Ghana. Somebody says Rwanda. What is the fifth option? The fifth option is Mozambique. Okay, let's have a look. Exim Bank gave LC of 245 million loan to Ghana and Mozambique for railway development. So Ghana agriculture, Mozambique railway development. So the answer for this is Ghana, not Mozambique. But for railway development, Mozambique is the answer, because this question asks specifically about agriculture. Next question, what is the total amount of FDI received by India in 2018 according to World Investment Report 2019? According to World Investment Report, total FDI received by India in 2018, that means FDI inflows in 2018 according to World Investment Report 2019. Let's have the answer, guys. 42, 70, 59, 65 or 45? Rohit says 42, Jayant says 42, Rishabh also says 42. Let's have some other answers, guys. Ritesh says 65, somebody says 70. A lot of confusion here, that's why these questions are helpful. FDI grew by 6% to 42 billion in 2018 compared with 40 billion in 2017. US received highest FDI of 252 billion in the world, followed by China. India ranked 10th position in FDI, still at 10th position. Okay, so these facts are very important. Please remember them. What is the most valued company in India according to Forbes Global 2000 largest public companies? HCL, Tata, Reliance, Wipro or HDFC? Most valued company in India according to Forbes Global 2000 largest public companies, Global 2000 largest public companies Forbes list, which company is the most valued company in India? Rishabh says C, Reliance. Juhi says Reliance. Santosh says Reliance. Bhadragiri says C, Anand says Tata. So some people saying Tata, some people saying Reliance. In the top 57 Indian companies list, Reliance is at the top, HDFC at second position. So the answer is Reliance. Which country is the fastest growing economy of Asia Pacific region according to Asian Development Bank? Fastest growing economy of not Asian region, Asia Pacific region according to Asian Development Bank. Japan, Australia, China, India or Bangladesh? Let's have the answer, guys. Fastest growing economy of Asia Pacific region according to Asian Development Bank. Santosh says E Bangladesh. Everybody saying E Bangladesh. Let's see what the answer is. According to Asian Development Bank, yes, Bangladesh is the fastest growing economy. Growth rate of 7.9% in 18-19. Bangladesh will have a growth rate of 8% in 19-20, according to Asian Development Bank. Next question, on which committee's recommendations has RBI increased the limit of collateral free loans from 10 lakh to 20 lakh for MSMEs self-help groups and beneficiaries of PM Mudra scheme. Diyosthale HR Khan, Nandan Nilekani, Usha Thorat or UK Sinha. Let's have the answer, guys. Yes, it is correct. Bangladesh because of low base. Yui says E. UK Sinha. Rohit says UK Sinha. Everybody saying UK Sinha. Perfect. Let's have a look at next question and then we'll go to the explanation. What is the new limit of collateral free loans for MSMEs, self-help groups and beneficiaries of PM Mudra scheme? This is how the question can be asked in the examination in another format. Same question. New limit of collateral free loans for MSMEs, self-help groups and beneficiaries of PM Mudra scheme. Already answered in the first question. Okay, perfect. Let's go to it. Has RBI increased the limit of collateral free loans from 10 to 20? Okay, and it is based on UK Sinha committee. PM Mudra Yojana was launched in 2015, not important. Let's come to the next one. What is the projected GDP growth rate of India for financial year 20 by Development Bank of Singapore? Development Bank of Singapore. What does it say about projected GDP growth rate of India for financial year 20? 4.7, 9.1, 6.8, 7.8 or 8%. Let's have the answer, guys. Projected GDP growth rate of India for financial year 20 by Development Bank of Singapore. Says Maharshi Juhi says 6.8. Everybody saying 6.8. Let's see if we are right in our answer or not. Everybody saying 6.8. Development Bank of Singapore says 6.8 for financial year 20. Inflation 3.8 for financial year 20. Okay, next question. According to recently released norms of leverage and capital adequacy ratio, stricter for housing finance companies, HFCs are required to bring down their total borrowings to dash of their net owned funds by 31st March 2022 as compared to the existing limit of 16 times. Let me repeat the question. According to recently released norms of leverage and capital adequacy ratios, it has made it stricter for housing finance companies and HFCs are now required to bring down their total borrowings to dash times of their net owned funds by 31st March 2022 as compared to the existing limit of 16 times. Somebody, Juhi says T 12 times from 16 to 12. A difficult question, I would say. MK says 12. Jayant says 12. Everybody saying 12. Is the answer 12? Darshan says E 10 times. Darshan says E 10 times. No problem if you don't know. It's a difficult question. Okay, let's see. National Housing Bank has made the norms for leverage and capital adequacy ratio stricter for housing finance companies because NHB is the regulator of housing in India. Total borrowings to be brought down to 12 times of their net owed funds compared with the existing 16 times. Currently, LIC Housing Finance is the only housing finance company to have the highest leverage ratio of 14 times. Capital adequacy ratio has to be increased to 13% by March 2020, 14% by 2021 and 15% by 2022. Tier 1 capital has to be raised to 10% against the current of 6%. So these are all probably changes made by National Housing Bank, and therefore they hold a lot of importance. The answer to this question is D 12 times. Please remember all of them. Yes, housing that has happened after June. So this is as per June and this is going to stay. This is not going to be scrapped. Next question, with which bank has the Bharat Financial Inclusion Limited merged? With which bank has Bharat Financial Inclusion Limited merged? Kotak Mahindra, IndusInd, Cookman, Bandhan or HDFC? Bharat Financial Inclusion Limited, with which bank has it merged? Let's have the answer, guys. Indus End, somebody says, a lot of students saying Indus End. Yes, Indus End Bank and Bharat Financial Inclusion Limited have merged. Anything else is not important. MD and CEO of IFIL, MR Rao. So new MD and CEO, MR Rao. Which company has developed National Freight Index? Let's have the answer of this one. A very important question. Very high chances of this question coming in the examination. Please try and mark this as a double start question. National Freight Index. Which company has developed this index? C-Rivigo, majority students saying C-Rivigo. That is the answer. Rivigo, a startup, has launched National Freight Index to provide live freight rates for over 7 million lanes and vehicle type combinations. Nothing else is very important. Minimum capital threshold for a company to act as a financial benchmark administrator as per RBI guidelines. So there has to be a minimum capital threshold if you want to act as a financial benchmark administrator. What is the minimum capital requirement? 5 crore, 1 crore, 7, 10 or 2 crore? 5, 1, 2, 5, 7 or 10. Let's have the answer, guys. Saranya says B. 1 crore, some people saying 1 crore, some people saying 5 crore. Okay, let's have a look at the answer. Financial benchmark administrator to regulate the significant benchmarks for financial instruments. Minimum capital 1 crore at all times, not 5 crore. It is B, 1 crore. Who heads the committee set by government to revise the wholesale price index? Who is the head of the committee which is meant to revise the wholesale price index? K. Subramaniam, Ramesh Chant, Amitabh Kant, Suresh Prabhu or Piyush Goyal? Let's have the answer, guys. The answer is 1 crore for the previous one. Saranya says B, Ramesh Chand. Okay, 1 crore still stuck with that. The next question is already started. B, Ramesh Chand. Okay, Happy says Chand. Juhi says B, Ramesh Chand. Ramesh Chand, all students saying Ramesh Chand. Darshan says A, K. Subramaniam. Okay, government formed an 18-member committee headed by Ramesh Chand to revise the wholesale price index. Okay, nothing else is important here. Present base year is 2011-12 for wholesale price index. Which bank is the sole issuer of electoral bonds in India? Which bank is the sole issuer of electoral bonds in India? I believe this question has been asked in some exams by IBPS. A very easy yet a very important question. Sole issuer of electoral bonds in India, which bank? SBI says Rohit. Rohit says SBI. D. Yes, the answer is SBI. Nothing to discuss here. Now we have appointments. Who have been appointed as the new chief of IMD? We'll be going fast this time. New chief of Indian Meteorological Department, IMD. Let's have the answer, guys. Jaya Devan, VP, Sivakolundhu, Prashant Kumar, M. Mahapatra or Ajay Singh. Who has been appointed as the new chief of IMD, Indian Meteorological Department? Rohit says Mohapatra. D, Mrityunjay Mohapatra. Let's wait for other guys' answers. Everybody saying Mohapatra. Yes, that is the answer. Next question. Next president of United Nations General Assembly. Who is the new president of United Nations General Assembly, UNGA? Maria Fernanda Espinosa, Mohammed Bande, Sam Kutesa, Morgans or Peter Thompson? Let's have the answer, guys. A very popular news item. Next president of United Nations General Assembly. Bande. Somebody says B. Bande. Juhi says B. Tijani Mohammed Bande. Everybody says yes, Tijani Mohammed Bande, Nigeria's ambassador to the UN, 74th president of United Nations General Assembly. Next question, who has been elected as the 9th president of FIFA? 9th president of FIFA, let's have the answer, guys. Wow, Havelange, Gianni Infantino, Sepp Blatter, Issa Hayatou, or none of the above. 9th president of FIFA. Gianni B. Gianni Infantino. Gianni Infantino re-elected as the president of FIFA till 2023. So you don't have to remember the name again till 2023. Who among the following is the first South Asian American woman to preside over US House of Representatives? First South Asian American woman to preside over the US House of Representatives. Kamala Harris, Patsy Mink, Mazi Hirono, Pramila Jayapal or Jesse Sumner. Let's have the answer, guys. First South Asian American woman to preside over US House of Representatives. Dheeraj says Kamala Harris, MK says Harris, Juhi says D, Pramila Jayapal, A and D, Pramila Jayapal, that is the correct answer, first South Asian American woman to preside over US House of Representatives. Who has been recently included in the American Philosophical Society? American Philosophical Society. Let's have the answer, guys. Amitabh Ghosh, Rohinton Mistry, Shyam Selvadurai, Romila Thapad or Arundhati Roy. American Philosophical Society. Students are getting a lot of appointments, questions also wrong. That means you have not done June properly. Romila Thapad. Yes, Romila Thapad and Kamaljeet Bawa. Kamaljeet Bawa, remember that as well. New MD and CEO of Yes Bank. It has been changed recently. Who is the new MD and CEO of Yes Bank as per now? As per today, who is the new MD and CEO of Yes Bank? Let's have the answer, guys. Ravneet Gill, everybody says Ravneet Gill. Yes, Ravneet Gill, new MD and CEO. Director General of Bureau of Police Research and Development. Director General of Bureau of Police Research and Development. Rakesh Agarwal, Suresh Murthy, Sudha Bharti, Keshav Bhargal or V.S. Komudi. V.S. Komudi. Everybody says V.S. Komudi. One second, please. Next question. Who has been appointed as MDO of Gift Company? MDO of Gift Company. Let's have the answer, guys. The answer is Komudi of the last one. New MDO, MD of Gift Company. Atul Kumar Goel, S. Hari Shankar Tapan Ray, Raj Kiran Raiji, A.S. Rajiv. These are the five options that you have. New MD of Gift Company. What is the full form of Gift? Can you tell me the full form of Gift as well? Sitapan Ray, that is the correct answer. What is the full form of Gift? Let's have the answer of what is the full form of Gift. Anybody can tell me what is the full form of Gift. Yes, overloaded with information, but we have to keep going on. Yes, Gujarat International Finance Tech City. Nice one, MK. That's the correct answer. Everybody knows it. Perfect. Next question. Who has been appointed as the Speaker of 17th Lok Sabha? Speaker of 17th Lok Sabha. Speaker of 17th Lok Sabha. Let's have the answer, guys. Okay, last question after this, because I believe majority of the students are overloaded with information. Om Birla, perfect. That is the correct answer. Last question. Who has been elected as the new Director General of FAO? New Director General of FAO. And how much time? New Director General of FAO and how much time? For how much time has he been selected? Last question for today, new Director General of FAO, Q Dongyu, that is the correct answer, Rohit, nice one. And for how much time has he been elected? Can anybody tell me that? For how much time has he been elected? Everybody giving the right answer. Yes, it's Q Dongyu. And he has been elected for 4 years. Nice. Good one. Ishani says 4 years. That's the correct answer. Jayant, no, the answer is 4 years. That is another question that can be asked in the examination. Okay. So that is all for today. I believe we have done a lot of current affairs. Majority of you are already tired. I am also very tired. It's been a long session, a total of 3 hours, I believe. Let's have another session very soon, probably tomorrow or day after, where I will revise entire October. So we'll try and cover entire October or at least national, international banking. They are the most important and most difficult to remember. Appointments and anything after that is easier to remember comparatively. So we will revise October next, probably tomorrow or day after, and then we will make sure that we go in confidently for the examination. Okay. Till then, all the very best. Take care. Have a nice day. Keep studying. Take rest of some time and then you can get back to your studies. Probably revise some more of general awareness. This is how you put yourself in pressure. More of active reading or active revision rather than passive revision will help you remember things for a longer period of time. Okay. All the very best. Take care.